Hi, I'm Elizabeth, and I'm here with Dr. Jason Pacos at Highland Hospital, where he is a cardiologist. So to start off, can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
I'm a cardiologist, which means I'm a doctor of the vascular system as well as the heart. I deal with a variety of medical conditions that people have, including heart attacks, valve problems, weakened hearts, high blood pressure, and high cholesterol.
What inspired you to first start studying medicine?
Well, my mom's a nurse, and growing up, she was a big inspiration. One of the doctors she worked for was a very interesting guy, and he took me into his office with him often and let me see a lot of interesting things, and that kind of piqued my interest.
And then how did you decide to specialize in cardiology?
So that's a good question. I had a lot of deliberation on what I wanted to do. And I liked a lot of different things as well, in medicine as well as in surgery. And I thought cardiology was a nice blend of both medicine as well as procedures in which you can see people over time but also do things in the acute setting to make them better when they're quite sick.
Can you take us through what a typical day would be like?
So my days can be very different depending if I'm in the hospital or in the office. When I'm in the hospital, we see lots of patients that are quite ill in the ICU as well as in the hospital after they have heart attacks and manage them. Sometimes the days start between 7 and 8 o'clock and can go pretty late depending on how sick people are. Often I can see people for a few minutes to a few hours depending on what's going on with them and what needs to be done. In the office, it's a little less acute. And when people typically have chronic conditions that we manage over time by adjusting their medications and monitoring things.
And what do you feel is the most fulfilling thing about cardiology?
I think the most fulfilling thing for me is getting to see people over time and be part of their lives and going forward and really have an impact on life and improve it.
So a lot of medical TV shows are very popular today. What would you say are the differences between real life and the TV shows?
Life is not that exciting, and the people are not that beautiful. but no, just kidding, is that on the TV shows, there's a lot of drama. And sometimes there's some drama in medicine, but it's not like that all the time.
Mm-hmm. How much schooling did you have to go through after high school?
So after high school, I went to 4 years of undergraduate and then 4 years of medical school. After medical school, I did 3 years of training in internal medicine and then another 3 years in cardiology. Doing the math quickly, that's 14 years after high school.
What high school classes do you think helped prepare you for your career in cardiology?
I think lots of the science classes are important and start a really good basis for your education going forward. So starting with your simple biology as well as the advanced classes in science are very important.
Are there any career shadowing opportunities or programs available?
Yeah, I think there's lots of programs through many of the hospitals in particular that allow high school students as well as college students to shadow as well as get other experience in the healthcare field.
Yeah. As a high school student who's interested in medicine, what is your advice for me?
I think that the most important thing is find something that interests you. When I was in medical school, I was surprised by how many people that were in medicine did not do the straight biology or other things in college. Lots of people did lots of different things, such as literature majors, theater majors, and if you have other interests, I think it helps you be really well balanced. And if medicine is an interest, by pursuing that in the long term, it's very important.
Well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to me today.
Thank you.